Have you ever
felt? Are you listening?
Hello everyone. Today we'll see how to create a comic style cartoon effect. Like this. So this is like the final effect and this is the original picture. So we'll see how to go from a regular photo to something like this. And also you need like to download this Halftone border in here if you want like to use the same effect that we will be using in this tutorial. I will make sure like to put this border in the link where you can download it and use it for free. Alright, fantastic, so let's get to it. Okay, so just open your Adobe Photoshop and drag the image that you want to use. And by the way, it has to be a higher resolution image. If you don't have it in higher resolution, like just go to image size and you know, just put 150 or you know 300 or whatever, like it's better like to be 150 because we will be applying a halftone effect to it later. So just make sure like to have you know higher than 72 resolution. All right, and now we just crop our image. Like it doesn't like it's not necessarily like to crop it, but it's better like just you know just use the face for this effect. So we just make it like this. And I will just use the face again, like that. All right, press enter. And now I will add a little bit of highlights to the image. So just go to image adjustment and I will choose shadow and highlight. And I will just add a little bit of highlight. It won't like be that much. So in the amount I will put 15 and in the tone I will put 20 and in the radius I will keep it 30 and for the highlights in here I will also put 15 in the amount and for the tone I will put 20 and the radius I will keep it 30 pixel in here. As you can see, it will just give it a little bit of highlights like this and press OK. Now I will create a copy of this image, so I press Ctrl G and I will call this lines and I will uncheck its visibility because we will use it later. And now I will go back to my layer in here and I will right click and I will choose convert to smart object because we will apply some filter to it and it's better like you know to convert it so we can you know just adjust wherever we want later if you want. All right, so the first filter we'll be using is we'll go to filter gallery and in the artistic folder in here just open it and choose poster edges in here. That will be our first filter and just put this in here. Just for the edges thickness just put 0 and for the intensity put 8 and for this one put 0 and press OK. As you can see, because it's a smart object, it will give it this option in here, filter gallery, where you can just edit it and you know just make it visible or invisible. So we will just edit it. We'll reduce the opacity a little bit, so we just double click to it like this and I will go to opacity and I will choose 70% and press OK. Now I will go back to filter again and choose filter gallery and this time we'll use a different filter. We'll use a cutout filter. So we'll just use these values. So put 6 in the levels and 4 in the simplicity and 2 in the fidelity and press OK. As you can see, it doesn't look that much now because it looks a little bit dense, so we need to reduce its opacity also. So just double click to it again and I will put 60% for the opacity like this, and press OK. As you can see now, for this last filter we'll be using for this image is a color halftone filter. So we just go to filter, and this time I will go down to pixelate and I will choose color halftone, and in the max radius in here just put 6, and in the channels in here just make sure like to have 45 on all the channels, and press OK. As you can see, it will give it a filter in here, a halftone in here, and it looks like, you know, a little bit blurry. So that's why we need to change its blending mode. So we just, again, I will just double click to adjust the options in here, and instead of normal I will change it to soft light, and I will turn down the opacity for like 70%, like this, and press OK. As you can see, it does look cool. Like, this is great, like, you know, you can just go back and, you know, maybe add more opacity or less opacity. You know, it's cool to have that options. So we'll go to my lines file in here that we created earlier, and we'll apply a filter gallery to it too. So we just go to filter gallery, and this time we'll go to stylize in here, this folder in here, as you can see, and open it and choose glowing edges, and we just, you know, choose this, keep it in here 1 and 4, 15, and the brightness 4 and the smoothness 15, and press OK, because this is the line that we will be using. So I will press OK, and again I will go back to filter and choose filter gallery again, and this time I will go to the sketch folder in here, and I will choose tone edges. As you can see, this will turn these two lines in here, and I will just make the image balance 3, and it's depend, you know, you will just, you need like to adjust and play with the image balance in here. Sometimes you will find it not, you will find it like this, sometimes, you know, just play with that. Alright, so we just keep it like this, and smoothness 15 and the contrast 18, and press OK. As you can see, and it does look a little bit sharp, so we need like to, as you can see in here, it's sharper that we want it. So we need like to apply a blur to it. So we just go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and we choose 0.5 pixel in here, and press OK. And now we just change the blending mode to multiply, and as you can see, it will make these lines appear more to the pictures. As you can see, it looks cool, like drawing. Alright, now we'll just add our border. So I will just go to my folder in here and choose this halftone border, this, and open it, and I will just resize it like this, and press enter. Alright, now we'll add a bubble text. So we'll go to custom shapes in here, and I will choose this bubble in here. I will make sure like to put this custom shapes in the link from description below, so we just download it if you want. I will just, by pressing shift, I will just draw a shape like this. Alright, and I will press Ctrl T so we can transform it and rotate it like this, so it looks like coming like that. Alright, something like that. Press enter. Now I will add a little bit of stroke to it, so we just double click and go to stroke, and make the position to inside, and just reduce the size for like 5 or 4 pixel, maybe 5, and press OK. Now we'll add a text, so we just go to the type tool, and the text I'm using is called Bada Boom. I will make sure like to put the link where you can download this text in here. Alright, so we just type comics like that. All right, and I will just replace it in here, and maybe Ctrl T, I will rotate it a little bit, something like this, and press enter. Now I will just double click to it, so we'll enter the light side dialog, and I will add a little bit of stroke, so just choose white color, and I will just make, you know, just change the size to 5 pixels, and I will add a little bit of shadow, so just go to drop shadow, and I will uncheck use global light, and I will put the angle of maybe like 135. And opacity, we'll turn it down to 30, and the distance I will make it 40 pixel or 35, and the size I will maybe 1 or 2, I guess maybe 1. All right, and press okay, and there you go. So it's that easy, and it's really cool effect to do. And you know, it's you know, it's, you know, just you can be custom as you want it, because we turn this to a smart object. You can always go back to the color halftone in here and double click to it, and you know, just reduce the size or increase it or reduce it as you want, maybe something like that. As you can see, it looks also cool like this, and there you go. I will make sure like to put this pasty in the link. You can download it and you know, just check everything I just did. And I hope this tutorial was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and wait for more tutorials to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.